Welcome, everyone, to Part 4, the final installment of Steve Jackson's Sorcery, Part 4, The Crown of Kings. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, the RPG chick. This is an interactive Let's Play where at the end of this episode you get to choose from the options going forward and will be chosen in the beginning of the next video. So, pretty excited for this. Now let's see, I remember last time this didn't work. Using local save game. Yep, same. Try this. So I'm going to blank this out, most probably. I like the way it comes up with the spell name, though. Pretty cool. Well, you can kind of see it there anyway. I think it's the same as last time. Because I want to show this part. We have 14 stamina, 26 gold, and no rations. Pretty typical, as far as rations go anyway. You defeated 6 of the 7 serpents, became a follower of Korga, and saved Kare from the marsh goblins. So we have 19 magical items, 1 treasure, 2 keys, and 5 weapons. Here are our items. Wow, we got quite a bunch of stuff here. We got a sword, a long sword. Well, one of them is minus 2, one of them is plus 2. Obviously, I prefer the plus 2. Hefty arrow, hewing axe, silver chain, whistle, monarch oil, detached beard. Some of this stuff I don't even know what it does anymore. Like, I may have known at one time. Human skull, a set of dice, giant net, tinderbox, walking cane, a snatticat's tooth, badge of the 7th noble, which I found way back in the... what do you call it? City of Traps, a fistful of gems, which we've yet to be able to sell to anybody. It's pretty expensive, but hey. Spellbook, of course, cloth skull cap, 3 pebbles, we can use them as exploding pebbles, 2 doses of blimberry juice, it's pretty good. Gives you, I think, 2 to 4 hit points back or something like that. Bamboo flute, a giant's tooth, a snatticat's tooth, they're separated. Green-haired wig, I think helps you read minds. Bracelet of bones, sun jewel, orb of crystal, holy water, jewel studded medallion, gale horn, stone dust, 2 jewels of gold, a snake belly key, which we ended up being able to use. That is, call it snake belly key because we found it in the belly of a snake. Kari gate key, which we used to get out of Kari, and a copper key, which I don't even know anymore. There's a legend. Long ago, or so they say, the ancient world was prosperous and free, from the Kakabad Sea to Lake Lumley. Harvests were plentiful, people were happy, music was loud, all was at peace. Even the thundering skies were calm, tamed by the arts of the sorcerers of Mampang. Then everything changed. A fearsome sorceress leveled the cities and turned the fields to dust with towers of devastating light. She heard no plea. Yeah, about that. Hold on a second. It's so loud. She heard no plea, cutting down village after village. The mages scrabbled to defend the ancient world, but they were weak. Finally, the last archmage sealed the walls of Mampang and sent out 7 deadly serpents to keep the dark sorceress away. They failed. Are you kidding me? I'm the bad guy here? I'm trying to defeat the evil archmage. I heard he did this to everybody. Sorry, I'm going to have to stop talking loud. I'm just talking loud over the music. The mages scrabbled to defend... What mages? I don't... One was a mage. He said he was a traveler. And he left me alone in peace. I think he tried to steal something from me. Yeah, they failed. All except one. So maybe the good Archmage can triumph. That's crazy, though. And now here you are, climbing the narrow pass into the mountains of High Xamen. The price of your journey across the Backlands has already been paid. Now the Annal Land is coming to Mampang, and nothing will be allowed to stand in her path. The crown will be yours. I don't want to be the bad guy. I didn't know what I was doing. Inkle presents. I didn't know the towers were destroying things. I thought it was going back into the past. They were like that before I got there. Steve Jackson's Sorcery. Part 4, The Crown of Kings. Sorry, I'm having trouble. Just to make sure everything's right, I'm going to stop and restart the recording here. Okay. The sky is already beginning to warm in the east. You climb an ancient staircase, the steps barely visible in the dark. Look back. Casting a regretful glance backwards, you can almost make out the glittering water of Lake Ilklala. It seems an age since you crossed that way. You shiver at the memory of the water serpent's clashing jaws. Check my provisions. You do not need to open your pack to check your provisions. You have nothing. But at least you have 3 portions of raw meat and fish, which will be edible if you can find a way to cook them. That's the thing. The raw meat we've had quite a while. In the distance, black smoke curls upwards. Let's check my sword first. You draw your long sword an inch from its scabbard, its edge flashing in the moonlight. The blade is decent, if hardly heroic, but it should suffice. Pulling up your hood against the freezing air, you stride onwards into the dark. You must not linger out here. All right. Let me take a look at the map. Wow. Like the edge of outer space. Okay. Argbad Crater. So, Mampang. Oh, I like how it turns around like that. And that's the Archmage's fortress. Oh, look. Looks like it might be an easy way through there. Some kind of little village before. A bunch of little towers here on either side. Some kind of table there or something. Has an axe on it, possibly? I guess it's not fair looking at so closely ahead when we're not even there. Look at that, a big fissure in the earth. So I definitely want to check out this house and some kind of shack or something there. Some kind of ruined something or other there. Looks like caves over there. We can go a variety of ways. If we could go, this way and that way and check out everything. Arg bad crater. Arg, it's bad. Alright, let's go up the steps. Oh, I have to click my character. Oh, draw a path. Like I don't know how this works already. You reflect on your progress with a heavy heart as you climb. The Backlands are a cursed place, and your journey across them was too slow. The serpent's message must have reached their master by now. Well, one serpent. You stride quickly up the winding stairs. The mountain pass. During the last day, you found no new clues. The Archmage is now waiting for you. Oh, goody. I suspect the Archmage might be me from the future, looking at my past self and, you're a jerk just as I remembered you be. It must be morning by now. You have been awake all night and are weaker for it. The Zanzunu peaks rise on either side like jagged teeth. The path winds back and forth as it climbs, and glimpses of the brooding horror of Mampang come and go. You should make progress while the sun is high. Sun's high already? I just woke up. Watch the skies. You watch the skies as you climb, staying alert for signs of the fearsome birdmen that patrol the peaks, the eyes and ears of the Archmage. Rough undergrowth. Rough undergrowth springs up, lining the path on either side. Look ahead. Ahead, the stairs curve away, out of sight. You can see nothing of what lies around the next corner. Search? Perhaps one of the acolytes who climbed this way years ago dropped something of use. You pause and push back the undergrowth with the blade of your sword, then jump as you disturb a nesting spikehawk. The creature flaps an alarm. Let's stay back, I guess. If I kill it, it's only going to be something else I have to cook. You stay well clear, and the hawk screams and flaps its wide wings, but does not chase you. Should I search for danger? Is it also going to warn the Archmage or someone else? I'm guessing it's still there. I could cause slowness, I guess, to it. Open locks and doors. It's a hawk, or stairs. Cause invisibility. Talk with animals. I kind of want to do that. Let's see what other options there are. Sharpen blade. DYRS. Create light. Sense danger. Cause depression. That's the most depressed hawk I've ever seen. Let's talk to it. Grabbing the wig from your pack, you pull it onto your head and weave your spell. Faint chitterings from the bush resolve into words. Worms! Screeches a tiny voice. Worms! Dark! Cries another voice. The spell is still in effect, so I can speak a greeting. Greetings, you declare. I am a traveler. A moment later, the bushes part and a mother spikehawk rises from the undergrowth. Intruder! Attacker! Beast! She screams. Her talons rise. Eyes! I mean you no harm. You reply quickly, the wig translating your intention into clicks of your tongue and curious squawks. Harm! The bird screeches back, rising higher. What can you tell me of Mampang? You ask. Mampang! The bird replies. Evil! Magic! Evil magic! I come in peace. You declare. Peace! The bird replies, settling somewhat. Back off. See if there's anything. Oh, now it wants to fight me. Jeez. You back away a pace. The bird hovers a foot above your bushes. A rage of wings. Blood! It screams. There's clearly no use talking to this creature. You remove the wig and the spell fades. But the bird continues to screech at you, growing increasingly angry, until finally it swoops onto you, knocking you back. I guess it's already knocked me back. Oh! Damn, I just missed that. The spikehawk swoops in low, talons outstretched, and you swing wildly, hoping to chop the creature from the sky. But the spikehawk has the momentum of its fall behind it. It knocks your blow aside and tears into your flesh. Owie! I beat you that time. You wait for the spikehawk's wide wings to open. Then your blade sings as it parts the air, overpowering its beating wings and tearing claws. Feathers drift down onto the stones. The spikehawk opens its beak to wail and moves upwards into the air. I guess I'll defend this time. Oh, maybe I should have attacked. You drop into a crouch. The spikehawk tries to slice you with its wings, but you duck. You escape mostly unscathed. The spikehawk beats its muscular wings hard and lifts up into the sky. What happened? I did zero? Huh. I've never seen that happen. It completely evaded me. This might be a more challenging chapter. An opening appears. You wait, twist, and charge forwards, but the Spikehawk reacts fast, lifting up out of reach. It escapes your blow. The hawk circles again, out of your reach. I guess if it's out of my reach, I should just defend? You fall back. The Spikehawk flaps around you, threatening but not connecting. The Spikehawk issues a bloody call and spreads its talons wide. We gotta do it now. Oh, damn it, beat me. Oh, crap. I'm definitely gonna be redoing this one. Next moment, the bird is plunging from the sky as though intent on skewering you with its beak. Your own strong blow is knocked aside as it batters you with its wings. Claws grasp at your side and cut a long, bloody gash. You're exhausted. You cannot see for blood and feathers and sweat. The Spikehawk rises. If it gets... yeah, even if I defend, it's going to take a point off, so... Oh, God! I can't even... what? I can't even hit the thing. Suddenly, you dive forwards. Swinging up from a low crouch, you aim for the beast's cold heart. But the... it has a cold heart, huh? But the beat only... the bird only circles and lifts. You strike at empty air. Your swing is wasted. The Spikehawk clicks together long talons while turning in the air once more. It is still determined to fight. Gotcha. Oh, only one off. That's right. I'm the one who has one. Now we're equal. Of course, I lost a lot more hit points than it did. You take advantage of the Spikehawk's anger to press forward. You cut a side blow. The Spikehawk swoops, then tries to turn and retreat, but it is too slow. Your blade cuts a ragged gash in its bony belly. Blood splashes from the creature's belly. It wheels high into the air, screaming in fury. Goodbye, cruel world. Wow. Then the Spikehawk is screaming in low as it punches you with its flapping fangs. Or wings, rather. Teeth are at your shoulder. Then you hit the dust, feeling the sharp dirt clawing at the wounds in your chest and neck. Try again. Because, damn. Okay, that first attack was really bad. So, I should either... defend. Or do something higher than cut. Let's see if I can charge it and then defend next round. This is gonna bring my attack power all the way down, guys. Gotcha! Four off! Nice! The Spikehawk swoops in low, talons outstretched, and you swing wildly, hoping to chop the creature from the sky. Your blade strikes deep, cleaving through the whirl of teeth and grasping talons. Feathers drift down onto the stones. The Spikehawk issues a bloody call and spreads its talons wide. Gonna defend now. You drop into a crouch as the Spikehawk comes at you furiously. You push the blow away, staggering backwards under the impact. You escape mostly unscathed. Spikehawk opens its beak to wail and moves upward into the air. Now, I'm not sure. Hopefully it's not out of reach yet. Oh, much better. You wait for the Spikehawk's wide wings to open, then your blade sings as it parts the air. The Spikehawk tumbles as it tries to lift itself away, but it cannot move its wings. It collapses to the grass, and the light in its eyes goes dark. One stamina lost. Skilled swordplay. Definitely better than last time. The hawk drops to the ground. The red fire in its eyes turn dark. Searching its nest. Returning to the bushes, you quickly find the bird's nest. Two tiny hawk chicks are burrowing deep into the straw, hiding from the light. Two more eggs are still unhatched. Take the eggs. I notice one ration. The eggs will never hatch without their mother, but they will serve you for a simple meal. You pick the first up carefully and wrap it in a scrap of cloth before putting it into your pack. One of the chicks tries to peck your hand as you reach for the second egg. Take the egg quickly. Moving quickly, you take the second egg from the nest. Then you wipe your sword and move on along the path. Cool. We got rations. I like that. two eggs. Oh, look at that, all our clues. Any might prevents the action of magic, and the use of silver weapons can harm the undead. Silver weapons. Now, this can harm them. Just checking my stuff. The lynch bug. We used it. We still have some left, I guess. Okay. I don't know what we do with the beard. That's for playing, what do you call it? God, the loud music stopped. That's for playing Swindle Stones, I believe. And this, yeah. I've never used it. I got this back in Chapter 2, I think. Kare. Keys. We still have those. Okay. Here's our treasure. I wonder if we can ever do anything with these gems. Okay. At the caves. Yes, I know about the rewind button. The air stirs a little, still cold, but fresh at last. You reach the top of the stairs. Rounding the corner, you find three cave mouths set into the rock. Look at the caves. You regard the caves with interest. The middle cave has the smallest entrance and probably opens into a niche and nothing more. The nearest cave would be large enough for a fire, but looks deep enough to contain any number of nasty surprises. A series of hoof prints leads into the mouth of the furthest cave. Look at the hoof prints, I guess. You take a closer look at the hoof prints. They are deep enough to suggest a large creature, but they are no longer fresh. They are at least a few days old. You also note there are no prints coming out of the cave. So, it's either still in the cave, whether alive or dead. Maybe it went out a different way. Who knows? Maybe it walked backwards to confuse me, and it's there's nothing in the cave. It left. I don't know. I don't want to use any stamina at this point. Create explosions. What, to draw whoever's in the cave out? Create strength, which I cannot do. Yeah, there's no other thing, right? Yeah. Heal disease. But why? Cause stupidity. Yeah, to myself by casting that spell. Safe passage. Uppercase D. Dop. Open locks and doors. The cave mouths. They're already open. Ah, screw it. If there is danger, I mean, there might be reward as well. Enter a cave or move on. The caves are unlikely to contain anything but nasty surprises, surely. Alright, let's check the shallow cave. I'm glad they actually, you know, are giving them names that we know them by the description, not just left cave, you know, north cave. Looks like the shallow one. You approach the smallest cave mouth and kneel down to peer inside. You might be able to crawl inside, but it would be a tight squeeze. Notice we can't go in. At least not directly. We can call inside, cast a spell, or just forget about it. And I'm guessing that would bring us back to the choices. Here we go again. What am I calling out for? Kin? Summon replica creature? Well, I don't even know if anything's in there, and I don't have the way to do it. Summon darkness. I think it would already be dark in there. That's a force field. Interesting idea, but it takes 3 stamina, which is a third of my stamina. Let's heal disease again. Are there disease things in these caves? Because I keep getting that option. Talk with animals. Is there an animal in there? See the future. I don't know. Protect from magic. It's anyone's guess as to what's in there. Magic? An animal? That's okay. I'm gonna try calling. You call a wordless greeting into the cave mouth, listening for the echo, ready to react should you disturb any creatures. Nothing stirs. As your eyes adjust to the darkness within, you can see that beyond the entrance, the space opens out somewhat. Do I hear a growl thing? Toss a stone? Guessing not one of my pebbles, right? You find a stone nearby and toss it into the cave. Nothing happens first. Then a shrill howling issues from the cave. Jump back. You leap to your feet, expecting something to rush you any moment, but still nothing emerges. A shrill howling. Alright, let's crawl inside. Stealing your courage, you crawl into the mouth of the cave. Alright. You are barely through the entrance of the cave when the howling noise sounds again. It is now somewhere terribly close at hand. Strike a light. You could use the tinderbox to make a spark. Oh, I'm not burning my spell. What the hell? You change your mind and put the tinderbox away once more. Stab with my sword. You go to draw your longsword, but there is not enough room to draw it comfortably. As you fumble and tug at the blade, the howl comes again, almost deafening you. Wait. I'm gonna crawl out because I can't use my sword. What the hell am I gonna do? I can't even fight the thing, so I'm crawling back out. Not even pausing to turn around, you shuffle quickly backwards out of the cave and into the open air once more. You step outside the cave to the ridge once more. A few clouds move across the heavens. The path continues on past the other caves. Let's try the large cave. You approach the cave mouth and peer inside. It seems to stretch back a long way. You know what? Let's eat one of these eggs. I wish you gave me more than 2 points. Smell the air. Okay. You pause to sniff the air. There's a faint, foul smell coming from within. Like an idiot, let's step inside. You take a few more steps into the mouth of the cave. The cave quickly opens into a wide chamber. You stop a short distance inside and look around, waiting for your eyes to adjust to the dark. Yeah, I hear growling again. Look, now we're given a chance to eat something. I'm gonna eat my last ration, though. I do have a blimberry potion. Search the back of the cave. You make your way into the back of the cave, which grows gloomier with every step. Then suddenly, your foot kicks something soft. feel downwards. Hello. Oh, my. Your feet... You feel carefully downwards, and your hand encounters something gentle. Fur. It's not so gentle. A moment later, something looms forwards, catching you with a heavy blow across your chest. You hit the floor, gasping. The creature in the cave roars at you. Claws outstretched, you have mere moments to react. Is looking at it count as an action? Use an item? Cast a spell. I don't know what item I could use against it. That would do any good. Cause slowness. Sounds like a good option. Illusion of treasure. I don't think this thing cares about treasure. Was there something else under you? No. Or O? Dop? What's Dop? Open locks. Yeah, I'm gonna try to open a lock and door. This is slowness. Yeah. Yeah, can't sharpen the blade. Replica creature? Cannot do. Create illusions. Kind of leaning towards that. Create illusions. What else do we have? DRK, Z, and R. That's lightning. Hover in the air. Probably won't make it up too high. I don't know how high the ceiling is, and it looks pretty big. I mean, perspective, but I have a feeling it would be able to reach me anyway. So what do we? Illusions and yeah. Bracelet of Bone. It won't take away any stamina, but create illusions of something. You cast a spell, and the bracelet at your wrist begins to glow. You have just a moment in which to choose your illusion. A wall of fire. You think it wouldn't be able to... I don't know if these illusions are purely visual or not. So... That's a good question, isn't it? The kid spell. Let me look it up. Well, they also feel the spell. I probably never got to use this. I never found the serpent ring. You guys hardly ever see me look at this. This illusion will become real to others. However, affected creatures must be intelligent, and the caster must not act counter to the illusion. Is it? It's too late now, right? How intelligent is it? A swarm of hornets. You summon up a swarm of hornets. The skunk bear, that's what it is, reacts quickly, turning around and lifting its tail, oh god, spraying a foul smell over the cave. You gag and retch at the terrible smell, and the creature keeps coming. The spells fades. The creature stamps its feet and bellows. You spend a valuable second looking at the creature. Its black and white fur and long bushy tail are unmistakable. This is a skunk bear, though far larger in size than those that inhabit the Shamutanti Hills. Use an item? Quickly, you flip open your pack to find something to use. Huh. The hefty arrow. Where'd I get that from, anyway? And what use would throwing an arrow do? I'm gonna see if I can avoid fighting this thing for now, guys. So, our choices. Three choices. Throw the hefty arrow, throw a joint of raw meat, or close my pack and attempt to use the run option. So, yeah, throw the arrow, throw the raw meat, or close the pack and run. What do you guys think I should do? Thanks so much for watching. See you in the next episode. Thanks for voting. And endure. And enduring, grow strong. See you next week.